As part of the National Instruments Applications Engineering Department, we were challenged to build a quadrotor UAV using National Instruments hardware, software, and a graphical system design approach. The controller was at the heart of the design, so this had to be capable of communicating with all the onboard devices, processing the data, and controlling the motors. The product we chose was the single board RIO. When combined with LabVIEW, this gave us the tools to achieve all of our requirements in a small, lightweight, low-power package. The single board RIO is an embedded device that runs a real-time operating system.
In order to interface with our radio receiver and to control the speed of our four motors, the FPGA provided the neatest and the most reliable solution. We needed to read in four signals from the receiver and then send out a further four to control the motor. And managing these eight signals on the real-time processor could be done, but it's going to introduce an unnecessary overhead and it couldn't be fully deterministic. We took advantage of the FPGA's true hardware parallelism to reliably manage the eight PWM signals simultaneously. Using LabVIEW FPGA, we were very quickly able to develop, deploy several iterations of the code that we would need to manage these signals, testing each one before coming to a final solution.
Once we'd finalised our key hardware, we then had a weight estimation for the quadrotor. This allowed us to specify our propellers and motors, and from this we had a power consumption, so we could specify our battery. We modified an off-the-shelf frame to allow us to mount all of our key system components and house the single board RIO. During the design process, we maintained a modular design approach. This allowed any component, should it be necessary, to be swapped out.
In order to control the quadcopter and achieve stable flight, it was very important to be able to determine its orientation. We chose an off-the-shelf solution provided by Xsense. The Xsense MTI contains gyroscopes, accelerometers and magnetometers, and it was able to provide us with accurate and reliable 3D orientation data. Using NIVisa, we were easily able to communicate with the MTI over a serial RS-232 connection.
For this project, we required wireless communications to transmit commands to the quadcopter and to retrieve in-flight telemetry. We achieved this connection using Bluetooth. We developed a pair of LabVIEW VIs, one which remained on our host PC and the other which was deployed to the real-time target. Once the serial to Bluetooth adapter was connected to one of the RS-232 ports of the single board RIO, we simply paired the device with a USB dongle connected to the PC. This enabled us to send the parameters including PID gains for the tuning of pitch, roll and yaw, allowing us to refine our control algorithms to achieve stable flight.
Since we were programming in LabVIEW, we were able to test the same code that was going onto the quadcopter on a simulated model on a PC. This helped us to learn valuable PID tuning principles without having to redeploy the code and run the quadcopter every time we made modifications. In the initial tests, we constrained our control problem to just one degree of freedom. This modularized the task so that we could verify each iteration of the code. The flexibility of LabVIEW is essential to the testing process, as we could redeploy code when necessary and update values wirelessly. We kept safety in mind throughout to ensure no damage was sustained to the environment, the quadcopter, or the team.